I got hit by a car while I was riding an e-bike. Dude, classic.
Sounds like a Pornhub title. Yeah. E-bike gets smashed by Ford F-350.
Step bro.
I always thought bosom was ass until like I was like.
You thought you were complimenting a girl?
I'm like, damn, look at that bosom.
Damn, she got two bosoms on her back.
I'm going to be honest though. Like, doesn't bosom sound more like an ass?
Yeah, that's why I was confused.
Bosom?
Bosom.
I don't know. Bosom.
Well, should we just intro?
Well, yeah, we're here talking about bosoms.
We're here talking about
legendary sex. Chad LeBaron. Am I allowed to say her full name?
I don't know. I don't want people finding my mom, you know? I guess people could find your mom. How do we find your mom?
People can find anything, dude. The internet's a weird place.
Yeah, you're right.
They can like find out who my third grade crush was.
Who was it?
Chad LeBaron.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
We're here with Chad LeBaron, a.k.a. the man Cherdleys.
Wedding videographer.
Wedding videographer. That's actually one of the questions people wrote in. They're like, what would you be doing if you weren't doing comedy?
Wedding videographer.
But wedding videos, all you do, I mean, I don't want to downgrade what you do, but you hit record in the back, and then are you like roaming around getting footage, or are you just kind of post up in the back?
Bro, I'm like running around like a madman.
All you have to do is get the I do though, right?
No, you got to get the whole shebang. They want like slow-mo of like their dumb cousin walking down the aisle.
The ring bearer, the dog.
She wants like lights like flickering behind her as she like walks down the aisle. Like she wants like that kiss.
Their expectations are like insane.
Oh, they're so insane.
Can you put us on the moon? You're like, this isn't a green screen.
They'd be like, here's $500. Like, yeah. And I'll be like, I can't hire anyone with that money. And then I'll just be like, zoom, God, they turned out pretty good.
It is weird that they like underpay, like you're documenting the whole trip and they're like,
yeah,
cool, here's $120 in a Slim Jim.
Yeah. And dude, a Slim Jim. Have some coffee.
Isn't wedding like all wedding what is it like videographers that I've come in contact, he's opening a monster. Opening a monster right next to the fucking microphone.
Yo, what? Check this shit out.
Oh shit, no, cover it up, dude.
Secrets. Is that you're revealing our secrets,
we're
dude.
Not fucking
we use monster
dude.
To hold up our fan art. Let's go.
You for the thumbnail of this, you should just Photoshop your face on me.
Dude, we're the same person. People will tag me and hit like it'll be like Matt Cherdleys, and it's a photo of me.
No,
people think
that's happened.
They think Cherdleys is a sketch group. They think it's more than one person.
Because I'm never in the thumbnail.
That also makes total sense.
Trevor's in the thumbnail.
But that also makes sense. It was an S Cherdleys. It seems like a
multiple.
Like it, yeah.
Multiple people.
Damn. So a singular version is Cherdley.
Cherdley. Yeah. That's what your name should be.
If anyone's like, I hate Cherdleys, they're like, which one? And then I just like go,
all of them, dude.
All of them. It's not my fault.
We have so much funny chemistry and questions, but I guess since there is so many things, do you have a favorite character that you've done where you're like, this is genius. Everyone, you're dumb. This is the best character I've done. Top tier.
I don't know. I feel like our Kyles are just like, we only did them like twice.
I know.
But like, I feel like you just like woke me up one morning. Like, let's film some Kyle shit. I was like,
yeah. Before Kyle was even a thing. It was just like, you want to break?
Because
originally the idea was just the kids who punch holes in the drywall.
Yeah. And we filmed it at the chill spot.
Yeah.
It
wasn't
chill that time. I think that drywall is still there. Should we give away where that is? Some
it's
people find run-in. It. Has anyone ever like sent
it's
it?
It's just
you?
By Runyon Canyon,
dude. Yeah. You know, there's a comic. Oh my god, you're gonna have Ari Shaffir.
Yes,
that like hides. I don't know if he still does, but he like when he's on a tour, he's where in Cincinnati, and he hides drugs around. And then he gives people on his Twitter like little clues. It's like a treasure hunt to find like mushrooms or a treasure hunt to find acid. But y'all should do
let's
that
give
with
a
the
clue.
Fucking drywall.
Well, I already said it's by Runyon.
Yeah. Well, that's not. I mean, dude, Runyon's massive.
Yeah,
that's true. It is.
Dude, that would be so fun for your fans, though.
Yeah, that'd be cool. So it's it's by a chimney.
Yeah, it's by a chimney. It's like a burnt down house.
Yeah, it's like on Runyon. Like,
whoa,
there's a
that's
path.
Pretty sad. You think there's a family in there?
Currently to this day, yeah, dude.
We're in there. We're a family.
Dude, that was our house. It got burned down. We used to live there.
The Cherdleys house.
Yeah.
Cherdleys. But yeah, I don't know. It's like off the beaten path, but it's one of those where it looks like it could be anywhere.
Yeah.
But it's so nice because it was like walking distance from where you used to live.
Yeah.
Just like be like, oh, let's go film here.
Felt like home.
Is that how most of y'all sketches come about, where it's just like, here's a loose idea, let's go fucking do it?
100%.
Pretty much, right? Yeah.
That's like the those first like time the we ever filmed ones. The video together. It's called Is It Chill If I Chill Here? Was like, that was at the place we're talking about in like Runyon.
Yeah.
Where Chad was just like, most of our like our favorite and like best videos have just been an idea where Chad was like, I want to have this, because the pitch on that, you were like, I just want to do a video about this guy who loves outdated memes. Where like, all the things I was saying, where the references were off, and then somehow it turned into that video. And then the other one I remember was the pizza boy at Coachella.
Oh, yeah.
Where you're like, I just want to bring 30 pizza boxes to Coachella. And that's the only...
And you were like, what?
That's the only itinerary. And I was very confused. And then like, you literally showed up with 30... pizza unfolded boxes. So we're sitting a little drunk in fucking Coachella weather, 100 degrees, and we're folding pizza boxes at a tent.
Everyone's like, what are you doing?
But that was like,
I don't know.
It's like, that's that like level of thinking where you're just like, I love it. Where it's just like, there's no plan, and you're just like, we're just gonna bring them and figure it out.
But dude, but that's why network TV sucks fucking dick, because there's too much planning.
Yeah,
there
was you can't do that guerrilla style.
No, it was that was the only planning of the day. And it's like, okay, you stay on this side, I stay on this side. And then afterwards, we just threw away 30 pizza boxes, which didn't fit in the trash can for shit. It was like stacked up
everywhere.
It was overflowing on the trash can. It was so funny.
So literally, that was the only premise of like, let's bring 30 pizza boxes, and that's it, you guys
and
riff
yell
the rest?
At each other pretty much.
Oh, it was just like, it just had dialogue yell.
And then we were like, let's just try to get in.
Fuck for 5 lines.
Fuck and rhyming.
Yeah, but there's been multiple videos where like, it's just the idea, and then, but that's all you need. It's just like, that's enough to propel it to whatever.
Same with like being dug in a hole in the
yeah
scene. The fucking, and yours that isn't here. Out yet. Or is this coming out after the ice cream?
Yeah, it'll be next week.
Okay.
Ice cream, you scream. Yeah, it was just like it's an idea. It's like, let's just rent ice cream trucks and yell at each other. But yeah, dude, I remember the one that people mean the most is the one where we're like both buried in the sand, sub little beach. That one.
Yeah.
It's so stupid.
Life's a beach and you're here, dude. That one. How you pitched that? We had been drinking the night before, and I was like, we're all hungover. This was the 4th of July weekend, and you're like, we're just gonna go to the beach and dig holes and like put ourselves in it. And I was just like, what are we even talking about? I like felt like shit. He picked me up at like 1 p.m. and we go to a Rite Aid and I'm hungover and I see these pink little glasses.
Yeah.
I was like, should I buy these
for
the video? And that's the glasses I use in that video, and I use them so much now.
Yeah.
It's the ones I wore for the hard summer video and all that. But it's just like,
oh, really?
But that's what was nice about it. It's not like we were up the night before being like, we need to wear this. You need to do this. It just kind of fell into place.
And then like Nick Coletti was like, let's film. And we go to his house. Him. Then we bring more White Claws. And then Kev just digs two holes in like 2 seconds somehow.
Yeah, it's just like, I don't know. It's like, you know, when people, you see piece of art in a museum, and then like the longer you look at it and the more details there is.
Yeah,
I feel like that's the majority of our videos. They're like, there's like little things in the background. They're like, I don't know if that was an intentional or not, but that shit's tight.
And some of it isn't. So it's like some like we get together like all these funny people, and then they just do weird shit. And
yeah,
then
like everybody just like tries to highlight themselves, and then just like just go from there.
I think like Kev was like burying himself.
Yeah,
Spencer was just under a bucket the whole time.
Hold on, Spencer was where?
He had a bucket over his head in this.
Oh yeah.
And then at one point you just like hear him talking.
Yeah.
But that's like this video we just did. Spencer's on top of the ice cream truck, and then he switches ice cream trucks without saying anything.
Yeah.
So like you'll be watching, you'll think it's an editing mistake, but it's like on purpose.
Yeah.
Which that's art, where you're like, I'm gonna make this look shitty on purpose.
That's the best things are like call it out. Same with like when you're doing like stand up, you're just like you're acting like this, like you look like you work at Stone. Like that probably just like that was the initial thought.
All like in the moment type of shit. Yeah. And one thing, it's like I like adding jokes after it's already been done. You do this with your subtitles a lot.
Oh yeah.
It's like your subtitles are a whole other story.
Yeah.
I was like, after the subtitle guy left and got bored.
Yeah.
But so you're talking about your old apartment. I want to go to that story we were talking about earlier.
Oh, God, me too.
One time, this was probably like 2.5 years ago. Oh, yeah. This is pre-girlfriend. A girl came out to see me at the Hollywood Improv, and we're talking for a while. And I was in between apartments. I was living at my parents' house at the time, which was like an hour away from
those
LA.
Were the best times, dude. Go back and live with your parents,
dude,
and bleach your
hair. Those videos were.
And bleach that your hair blonde.
That was when I did the Kyle video, the frat guys come home for summer, and the White Claw video.
Wait, no, and entrepreneur. Was,
and the
quarterback dude.
The guy who never left his hometown.
Yeah. And entrepreneur.
Was entrepreneur, I just moved into my new place.
Because
did you not have blonde hair in that one?
I did. Blonde hair with King Trevor.
So Trevor blonde with blonde hair.
I think about that sometimes. I go, blonde hair. I need to move apartments and I need to get blonde hair.
That was so like
give me your hair.
That was so out of character for you.
I know,
just to be like, yo, blonde.
You guys all called it. Oh, that was the second Kyle video. You guys all called it. I was like, I did it for the Kyle video. And you guys were like, I think you did it because you want to do it, but you don't want to say out loud that you did it to like blame it on something. Oh, I need to do it for a character.
Yeah.
Dude, I saw that in the video and I literally text you immediately. I was like, this
isn't real. Well, dude, it looked like shit. It looked like a brand new penny from like 2021. It had this bronze. The amount of DMs that I got that day from women or just like hairstylists that were harassing me, like, you need to put the purple stuff in your hair. You need to tone it. You fucking bitch. Your mom doesn't love you. You unathletic piece of shit. You read at a seventh grade reading level.
You're not going to make any good content while you have your hair blonde. Jokes bitch, you were wrong.
Jokes fuck on you, bitch.
Yeah. It's so funny.
Non-conventional,
but like, I'm such a superstitious dude that like part of me thinks like that. I was like, oh, yeah. Should I go back blonde? I've told him this 1,000 times. If I do a show and I wear an outfit, let's say I wear this outfit on stage tonight, I'd be like, it wasn't the fact that I need to write better jokes. It was like, oh, it's the outfit. That's what fucked it up. So with the hair thing, I was like, yo, blonde hair, maybe I should go back.
Yeah. Look, I bought these shoes in Portland the same day. I was like, oh, these are tight. I love these. Went on stage with them, had a very average set. Have never worn them on stage again. These are my bombing shoes. Yeah. Get them out of here. I use these to take Greta out and that's it.
Really?
Oh, fuck those shoes.
Yeah. Oh my God.
I hate them.
You should sabotage somebody. You like give them that. Yo, wear the shoes on stage. No, they're sick.
Nice, yeah,
dude.
Some comedian you just don't like. You're like, dude, these are sick. I didn't use them that much.
There's everybody that like opens for you, like, it's really weird. He makes you like wear some shoes.
I've never done well when I feature for Mike. I bomb every time.
What shoes are there? Are they something crazy? Like,
no, they're very generic. They're like they're Prestos, like just all black Prestos. They're like very regular shoes.
Damn. I did that like even like when I was like a teenager, like pre losing my virginity, and like I would have specific boxers.
Yeah.
Like I would wear my best boxers.
You're like, Shelby's in my science class. Yeah, Shelby's here today. Let's go. It's Wednesday.
She has X-ray vision to see that I have good boxers. Right. Maybe but she'll want to touch my fucking
better.
Will.
You feel better.
I had this
orange
sweater. Sweater that I used to wear to parties, and I wore it one time.
The brightest thing you wear to a party.
Oh, bro.
I hope people notice me, dude.
Literally, bro.
This fucking fire jacket.
Like, was it plain or did it say anything on it?
No, it's clean. It was like a orange sweater with like this kind of like cream colored.
Said like savage on it. Or something?
No. It was just like it
was
lines. Like,
was this at the time you had the orange car?
No, it was before.
Oh God, I was gonna say if you're pulling up orange car, orange hoodie, then just like this guy just loves cream pops,
dude. Orange sweater, and then I had ears pierced walking into parties. But the first time I wore it, I hooked up with like a super hot girl, and I was like, "Oh, this is my fucking sweater." And nice. I didn't want to overuse it because in my head it's like there's a limited amount of fucking in this sweater. So it's like once a month. If I'm like, I'm trying to hook up with something hot, boom.
Did you ever accidentally wear it on accident? You're like, Michael, meet us here at church. And then you're like, oh my God, the only thing I have is the orange thing.
And yeah,
then you show up to church
pastor.
And you're like, well, the pastor is probably getting after you. Anyways,
hey,
dude, that's so weird. I had a dream that we both at church.
Me and you?
Yeah.
Next video. I'm Jewish, you're Christian, and we beat up at church.
Fight.
I'm just in the audience. Fuck you.
Shut up, dude. You're not even baptized. I'll baptize that ass. I want to get back to this story real quick.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, I do think we should do that. We have so many video ideas we never do that we just like.
Yeah.
Whoa. Pinky way high when you drink. Is that normal?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude.
Like, it's not even a little.
Ever since
like
that SpongeBob episode, when in doubt, pinky's out.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Also, yeah, I do that in front of girls.
Is that where the rhyme
came that's my
from?
Superstition. I'm gonna fuck today. Dude,
one time I was on a date with a girl and I parallel parked on the first try. And like, there was a split second where I was like, she thinks I'm hotter now. I was like,
dude, this is like a swift parallel park.
Yeah.
Dude, my ex-girlfriend, she couldn't do the
park. She left you?
She's gone.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, shit. She couldn't get the park. She couldn't get the parallel park. And I'm like, oh, babe, I'll do it. I get in, two fucking bang, bang. And she looked at me. She goes, you're so hot to me right now.
Well, okay, so
and
it
I
works.
Was like, oh, dude. Top me off in the jet a bit.
So everybody listening right now, learn a parallel park.
Yeah,
learn. But dude, a swim parallel park, is that just the dad in me that's like, yeah, I got it.
Yeah.
Goddamn.
Hello? Who's calling? I'll tell you who's calling. That's Skin, SKYN. And what do they sponsor? Our penises. And ladies, your cooters.
Cooters.
Okay.
Skin creates products for those who know what they want and who are not afraid to demand it. That's right, demand it, okay? Those who choose to feel everything, not just in the bedroom, but in life. Skin products are designed using the very latest technology to help you and your partner create a truly intimate
sexual... You mean skin-timate?
Oh! They should use that! From condoms to lube to massagers and more, skin products embodies the mission to feel everything.
And speaking of lube, they also have what? The delay spray.
Where is it at?
Look, you put this on. This is like a buffer for your fucking ding dong, okay? You put it on and it helps you last longer. Now, look, I know all of male listeners of this podcast already have a problem of lasting too long because we have too much sex and we're too good at it. But now we can make it last even longer.
Let me tell you something. I used it. Y'all know in college. And let me tell you something. Does it delay your cum? It delays your goddamn cum. You can literally go for an hour. She's like, please, I love it so much. Keep going. You're like, bitch, I can keep going.
Yeah.
Because it just
turn your dick into click. All right? Be in control of the
let's
time.
Let's go, dude.
Bars, keep it in. Anyways.
But it has everything, dude. It has freaking vibrators. My girl's in London, and when she comes back, she's about to get vibrated. Is that an iPhone in there? Yes.
And also non-latex. So if you're allergic, or also a lot of girls are allergic to latex, they're non-latex, and they're the number one non-latex condom out there, baby. It's the closest thing to wearing nothing, all right? And it's available in a wide variety to enhance sex for both your partners. How you guys choose. That's up to you. Go to skin.com and get free shipping on orders over $30 in the US, okay? Or go to Amazon. They're on Amazon.
They're on Amazon?
They're on Amazon.
So you're saying I can order delay spray on Amazon right now?
I'm already in.
Whoa.
I'm already wearing
watch,
it.
Watch,
right
I can't even feel my dick.
Cut it.
Goddamn.
One of my exes, she was rich, and she was like, "I've never had to parallel park," and I'll just
the
swift right
thing
in.
Ever.
What?
What is? What? She's
that's
always
the, that sounds like the richest thing ever.
Yeah.
Like I don't know, they just have huge garages, or like they always valet, or
but you need a parallel park to get your license.
She just gives them a 20, and they're like, "You're right, man.
Yeah.
Here's 20s and a Wendy's Frosty. Yeah. Shut up."
Yeah, she's like, "My mom paid me to get a USC. I could fucking pay this guy to get a license."
Dude, that is.
They
funny.
Always pay for parking. They
did you guys
never...
pass your driver's test the first time?
Yeah, no, but I was going 25 an hour. I didn't do the good at the written thing. Test. And then I
oh, right.
And I was going 25 an hour in like a 45. And they were just like, I know you were scared to go 45, but just you were going
rev it
really
up a little
slow.
Bit,
rev
yeah.
it up a little bit. I'm like, I'm so sorry.
And I'm so
like,
sorry.
Let's go. My mom probably like did something. She's like that.
Yeah, like, I remember if you hit the curb. Like when you're reverse parking, you automatically fail.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. At least for where I'm.
No, me too. Parked.
Yeah. Parallel.
Well, dude,
parking,
I hit the curb like probably like 5 minutes into a 15-minute test. So the whole time I know that I already failed.
Yeah.
So then I accidentally I ran a red light on accident.
Oh Jesus! Dude.
I was just so nervous, but it was a green light with a red arrow, and I was like, green light, you have the right of way. And then she's like, you realize that's a red arrow.
Just sweating.
No.
Dude.
Yeah, I mean, at that point, I already failed, so I was just crying. And then I just went to a different DMV. Anyways, driving. This is a funny story.
Okay,
get back to this. Had a show at the Hollywood Improv like 2.5 years ago. I was living at home in my parents' house, and I was commuting to LA to film and to do shows, and a girl came out to visit my show. And then she was like, you know, well, what are you doing tonight? This and that. She was hanging around. I was like, oh, shit. Papa Giorgio over here needs to make a move. And then I was like, what? And you said this earlier. You're like, why didn't you just get a hotel? I don't know. I was in my head. I was like, "Oh, I could drive you to my hometown and try to hit at my parents' house."
Yeah, just fucking the garage.
And that's what I was gonna say. But garages always smell weird. And she's
awful. Yeah,
getting she's clapped like, out. There's a bunch of like bicycles on the ceiling.
Yeah, she's like
holding on to the pegs.
Don't fall.
That's actually a fantasy for me. Like, come over right now.
There's a lawnmower in my ass. I don't
wear this
like
helmet.
It.
So,
yeah, because it's not like you were like broke.
No,
I mean, listen, $200, $150 for a hotel. That's
yeah,
annoying.
But when you're horny, you'll spend that.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Here's the thing. I would have spent that same amount of money to Uber her home because she didn't even live in LA. She lived on the outskirts of the opposite direction. So it would have been like a two-hour Uber.
Dude,
so
I was in Huntsville, Alabama, and I spent $200 on a fucking hotel. Just horned up. Woke up pissed. Pissed.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, $200 to bust a nut?
Okay,
too
but,
much.
But there's guys that go to Vegas that spend $20,000.
And then they don't even bust them.
That's true.
And then get blue balls.
Yeah.
And then they have to jerk off to those cards they got on the way back to the hotel with all the stars over their tits.
Guys really do go the limits.
Yeah. So this, but I don't know why I didn't do that. It didn't cross my mind. And then there's a point where we're like, I was like, you want to go back here? And she's like, she's thinking about it. She's like, I could. The drive back is fine. And she goes, and I was like, all right, whatever. It's fine. I was like, it's not going to happen. It's okay. And she goes, can you drop me off at my friend's house? And I was like, sure. Is it nearby? And then she gives me the address. And I start driving there. And I go, God, this is awfully close to my good friend Chad's house.
No. Shut your mouth.
And then it's like where he lived, it's like it would be an insane coincidence if it was somebody else's. I go, are you going to Chad's place right now? And she just starts laughing. And I was like, so
how did she think she would get away with it?
I was like, I've been here so many times. This is why I filmed the White Club video. You think I forgot about this shit? But so I was like, are you saying no to getting piped from me to get dropped off at Chad's house so he can just, because this was after a comedy show. I lubed her up with the jokes. She was like, this guy's great. He's funny. And then I just warmed it up for Chad. And then
You were my opener.
I was the opener for you. And all you had to do was just watch a Transformers movie and sit on your bed and be like, come hither.
Hold it. Were you at the show?
I didn't know that she
was just
chilling
at his apartment.
Yeah.
Oh, so you
he didn't
so
know
you,
that.
Yeah, I didn't know that she was getting a ride from Trevor.
She thought I was just.
Or I would have been like, come up, bro.
Let's just dap each other up in front of her.
That would have been so funny.
And then, yeah, she left her friends that she was at the show to like stay in town and like go home or like do something or like have a night or something. And she just thought an Uber driver dropped her off at Chad's house and that Uber driver was me.
Did she at least tip you, dude?
Yeah, did she
didn't
tip?
Do shit, dude.
Did she even do anything to the tip?
Chad's, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was just... It was pain.
She was all dolled up, too. She was trying to hook you. She was wearing, like, red lipstick.
Cute. And then I just had to drive an hour home to my parents' house that night.
It's like, fuck.
I hope he fucks, dude. That was so sad. That was worse than when you do bad on stage and then you have to, like, drive home an hour. I was just literally in the car and be like, I'm getting no pussy.
That's so funny. I don't know if I knew. Did I know like right away? Did you text me or anything? Or did I just not know till the next day and you're just crying on the way home?
I just sent you the crying emoji.
Should we send her a picture? I still talk to her. She's a really nice sweetheart. Girl. Yeah. She laughs at everything you say really hard.
Yeah, you feel hilarious.
You feel there. So funny.
Is it disrespectful that I want to see a picture immediately?
No. Okay. Like you could be like, the word baguette is kind of weird. And she's like, oh my God, bread. Yeah. Ha 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 ha.
Baguette is weird. What? There's two T's and an E? At the end? Yeah.
You know how to spell like that? That was crazy.
Dude, but here's the thing. We had a...
Is that how you spell it?
Dude, we had a night.
I don't fucking know.
We were like taking photos on the pink wall. We were just having a night with each other.
No way.
Dude,
it
you
went
guys
to
were
that
having
extent?
A pink wall night?
Oh,
dude,
no.
I mean, at the,
and I'm just
at the improv,
there.
You know...
Can you scroll more? I'm not even joking.
Let's see. Wait, you should see if she's DM'd you ever.
No.
Not for you?
No. Oh, no.
What do you mean, no?
No, because well, I said, no. I said, can you scroll more? Because the first picture looked like someone that I, so I was like, I need to see. Okay, yeah, no.
What are you saying no to?
No, like.
Does she follow him?
No, if we're being honest, you showed me the first picture and I was like, I might have hooked up with that person.
Yeah, okay.
So then I was like, because Chad and I have this weird thing.
You guys
like,
we have a weird
15 Eskimo fucking brothers, dude.
Something's happening in the air, but we're Eskimo.
Yeah, I don't
brothers.
Know what it, do girls have just like a Yahoo message chat where they're just like, this week Michael hooked up with so-and-so and Chad's like, ahaha.
I'm next.
Sure,
get
shaving by fitness swoop.
I will say,
Trevor's living with his parents right now, just don't talk to him.
Everybody have sex but Trevor. That's the problem.
I will say every girl, you're always first.
Really?
Wait,
how many are there?
I feel
how
like
many
there,
are there?
There's probably some that you know about, you don't know about, but vice versa.
Oh, maybe. Yeah.
All right, dox them right now. Say their names.
Yo, here's their number.
dude, that is wild that you dropped.
That's so funny.
Off.
Pain.
I didn't know you had like a little day or a little night with her.
Did you get froyo? Did you get froyo?
I wish. Dude, it's so sad because where the Hollywood Improv is right across the street from where Melrose, there's like that pink wall where everybody takes photos of.
Yeah.
And it's like, we were just having a night. And
oh my God.
The whole time I was
worse.
Just like feeling out, be like, is she laughing because she thinks I'm funny or is she like actually trying to hit on me and be like, this is a thing?
And she's one of those girls where you're like, are we in love? You know, like one of those girls that like, dude, they seem like
so
they're
funny.
Like, yeah.
So my...
Like strippers can do that too. Hold on, we're in love
We're
now.
In love.
Oh yeah. Dude,
here's all my money. We're in love.
Here's a brand new Dodge Challenger. I love you. So my iCloud deleted like everything almost, but for whatever reason, when I went back and checked the photos, I still have the photos of us.
Oh my God.
Can I show the photos?
Of you guys?
Yes.
You got someone like take like pictures.
Dude, we did like self-timer photo.
No,
I was in love with this girl.
No.
And Chad literally just swooped.
No way.
Dude, what? That's so funny. I found the photos of us on the beach.
Hell yeah.
This is the day we filmed that Life's a Beach and You're Here, Dude video.
Wow.
Okay, let me, hold on. Let me find.
Where were you, bro?
This was.
You haven't been in any of my vids.
Well, text me, dude.
All right, I will.
Dude, it's got. Hell yeah. Oh, we're getting close.
I'll text you unrelated to that.
About who you guys are fucking that
another,
week?
Another video that was really
oh my
funny.
God, I found him!
Yeah!
Oh my God!
Dude, like, this is us, like.
No! Those are, like, cute photos. Oh my
right? God. Right? I was like, take photos of me being a fuckboy in front of the wall. Like.
Oh my
no!
God.
Dude. You guys had a night. I didn't know this.
Dude, we had a night. That and then you sucks. Just piped her out.
Dude, hold you should have just took my room for a few hours. I don't give a fuck. I didn't know until like you were driving home, I think. I would have just been like, come up, bro.
It was honestly just so funny. I was just like, my life's a simulation. Like, out of all the places she went in Los Angeles.
She should have said like a few doors down and just walked up.
But even then, we would have found I could have reversed and then I see her walking up the hill. I was like, there's only a few people that live in that area. I was like,
yeah.
Fill me in on one thing. So, did you hook up with her prior?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay, okay. That makes it slightly better.
Yeah, it makes it a little bit better.
Okay, okay, okay.
Cause yeah.
Damn, dude.
Just
how was that drive home?
Oh, terrible. Every exit, I was like, what if?
Yeah. Every hill, you're like, I'm going down Runyon Canyon.
I'm driving up to Runyon. I just go to the chill spot. Just like, I'm like, I'm homeless now. People are like, Trevor, we can see you from the path. Yeah, dude, I forgot that's about that story, but it was story. Just such a funny. I don't think
you
she
guys have
that.
Like a Lady in the Tramp moment. And then she's like, here's another. She's like, I'm going to go run off with this other mutt.
Yeah, dude, so funny. So funny.
There's no way she didn't know that y'all knew that.
Yeah. What was she playing mind games?
I know. Like 15 videos deep at this point. Yeah. There's no way.
And she told me before.
I was
she's like,
probably there that day at some point too, like earlier in the day.
She said that she was going to your show. I was like, oh, cool. And so I knew she like knew we knew each other, obviously.
No,
yeah.
Dude.
I don't, but again, I think women think we're the same person. So they're like, if I can't hook up with Trevor, I'm hooking up with Chad. And if I can't hook up with Chad, I'm hooking up with Trevor. And then she's like, if I hate myself, I'll hook up with Ryan Leader. Shut up!
We know you're watching.
You,
we know you're watching in Salt Lake. You're bored.
Anyways, yeah, that's just a funny story of.
That's so funny. That went deeper than I thought.
Yeah. I didn't go deep.
I want to give you a hug, bro. Oh, damn.
Did you, for sure you jerked your cock off.
I probably jerked off the second I got in the carpool lane.
You're like, yeah, Mom, don't talk to me. The carpool lane. You're like, I got two people in this car. Me and my fucking thousands of babies.
My depression. I mean, so funny. So funny.
Oh, shit. We have a lot of weird stories where like, there's no reason you should be like still talking to me. Like the Coachella one. I was like so hyped. I think it was like the last night or something.
Is this and the, like, you're not going home?
Yeah, yeah. And that's I was like, so, I wasn't too drunk. So I still remember like everything. Like it was clear as day. But I was just being so
last
annoying.
Night after like a 4-day bender in Coachella. You're just.
I was on
you
a
just
level.
Want a shower or a bed.
Yeah.
Can you, I'm sorry. I've never been to any of these festivals. Can you walk me
really?
Through like what, dude, like when you say bender, like, is it just like having showered, just drinking all fucking day,
yeah,
drugs?
Yeah. You have like a Nutrigram bar at 9 a.m. and then you just drink a fuck ton.
Yeah.
And you're just like, you might take Adderall like 10 and then just like, it's like 10 o'clock at night and you're like, how have I gone 12 hours?
Right.
Yeah. My body is just running on few.
Your body's hurting, but your mind's like bazinga.
Yeah. Your brain's like, your body's like, no.
But
it's just like, it's like you hit a certain point where it's like you're having the best time of your life, and then you snap and you go,
yeah,
I need to go home right
I
now.
I need to
right,
go
right.
home.
And then so we're all splitting an Airbnb. And
we're like 3 hours away
I
from LA.
I was coming from Arizona, actually. I remember
that's right.
Because I did a show out there, and then I met you guys there or whatever.
You were dead asleep.
I think, which is
normal.
We were all leaving the campgrounds at like 4 a.m. or something. And Chad's like, I'm going to stay. Which is never something that's a smart decision.
No, never.
So he was like, I'll meet you guys back at the house.
Yeah.
And I was so tired and I'm asleep on the couch. And sure enough, at like 5:30 a.m., Chad opens up the Airbnb door he just starts yelling. And I think Spencer was there. This is the first time I'd met Spencer. Spencer's like, Chad, yeah. you gotta relax.
Yeah, everyone's
telling
like, me to
look
relax.
At me on the couch. You're like, look at this idiot yelling. And I'm like, no. And you just kept, and it'd be so weird. You'd just be sitting there and then you just start laughing. For whatever, you couldn't go to sleep.
And
you just start laughing really loud. And I'd be like, Chad, please stop. And then eventually I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going home. And Chad was so hammered. He goes, dude, you're not going home.
And it's just like, you're not waking up and going home?
For like the next, it felt like an hour. The next hour, like every like 4 minutes, Chad would just be sitting there laughing and be like, dude, you're not going home. And that's just like a joke to this day where he'd be like, dude, you're not going home. I was just so mad. I was so tired.
So funny. Like, please. There's no way you should have just punched me in the face. I would have been like, yup.
But it was like this like wholesome like laughter. Like, you know when somebody at a comic club is drunk, they're not disrupting, but they are because they're just like laughing really louder. They're just happy to be there.
That's what it felt like.
It was like Chad was having like the best time of his life just being like, dude, you're not going home.
It was just so fucked up. Everyone hated me. God.
Yeah, man. It's
how long did that last for? You came in at 5:30. Was it the whole thing?
It was probably like a good 20-minute like being loud, but it probably felt like so long when you're half awake.
And then I'd fall asleep and then I'd hear it, dude. Not going home. It felt like a fever dream.
Holy
I was like, please get me out of here. Get me out of here.
I used to, when I first moved to LA, I slept on like my, like a love sack, like in a living room.
A
beanbag. Yeah. Okay. There's a brand called Love Sack. I think they're like the most popular ones. Fucking your love sack, bro.
Dude, you love my sack, bro.
And it was like, we just moved out. So everyone just gets drunk every night at like 18 or 19, and like they would come home and I would have like work or something in the morning, and it would feel like a fever dream when you're just like, everyone's like,
that was like my just senior year to sleep. Senior year of college, we all lived in one house, and it was like Saturday night, like four of us would like stay in, and then like two guys would go out.
Yeah.
And like when you go out and you're drunk, you like have to let your boys know that you're home.
It's
illegal to come home. Dude, quietly
wake up, bro, we're raging.
What the fuck are you doing sleeping? Just the most logical answer.
It's a big like fuck you, you're a pussy.
Work tomorrow, or are you trying to make money? And it just
okay I'll be quiet, but they're still whispering like this loud.
They're making fucking like Italian sandwiches loud as shit in the kitchen. What are you doing
I'm cutting
where did you get prosciutto at? Dude, but you'd also make the loudest plans ever. You'd be like, yo, we should go fuck with John.
Yeah.
Let's go fuck with John.
I'm right here.
He's like in the room. He's like, God damn it.
Yeah. You could hear him like jiggling the door.
Shh, John. You fucking bitch. Bang, 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 bang. He's like, God damn it, dude.
The drunk, they're so loud. You're so screaming.
You're
you can quiet an auditorium with it. But it literally sounded like a teacher at a fire drill and getting everyone quiet. But there's something about somebody who doesn't drink when you're drunk. You're like, this is you're a pussy and I'm above you in every level possible.
Of course. You're not going to make it. Like, you should have got aborted at 6
a.m.
Even if it's like the one time a week that you go like rage. Pussy!
Yeah, you drink once a year. I remember I'd like occasionally... when I lived in Santa Monica, my two other roommates were like, they would go out every weekend and I was doing like shows or trying to film or whatever. But the one night I'd go out on like a Tuesday randomly, I would let them know.
Yeah.
Yo, I'm not a bitch like you guys. Fuck you.
One time I did that to my roommate. He just got back from like the UK and he was super jet lagged.
Yeah.
So he took like muscle relaxers that put you in like a deep sleep.
Oh,
and
shit.
I banged on his door. So he like woke up and he thought I was like a sleep paralysis demon.
Yeah.
And he just sat up in his bed and he like was standing and he's like, get out. He was just saying these words like, leave. Like he thought I was like a demon. That was the only time I was like, oh, my bad. Usually it's like, dude, fuck off. You're like, fuck you, dude. But I felt bad.
For real. He's like, get out.
Dude, he thought I was literally had like a third eye and like horns. Jesus Christ, that was funny.
Dude, real quick, I know that, Trev, you know all this stuff. I don't, though. Where you said you moved out to LA when you were 18, 19?
From where? From Marietta, like 2 hours south from here, by Lake Elsinore. Lake Elsinore represent, bro.
Oh, so not Georgia, Marietta here?
Marietta, like what 2 hours.
Is it like, by that casino, kind
of? Yeah, Pechanga. Pechanga, bro. Let's go to Pechanga, right out of suite, dude. And lose all our money.
Pechanga.
And then meet some MILFs down there, dude.
So,
And then it's like San Diego or LA, San Diego, and it's like here in the
middle.
It's like the Sacramento of SoCal.
Yeah, we drove down there for a video once.
Like elsewhere.
All the way down. Yeah. And you had like a show that night. We were driving back, I was like, I don't know how this motherfucker is going to do this.
Dude, it was great times.
Goddamn. This podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp.com. Is there something interfering with your happiness or preventing you from achieving your goals? BetterHelp will assist your needs and will match you with your own licensed professional therapist, okay? I started using therapy and I like it. I question a lot of things, but I think that it's good because it's not a yes man in your corner. It's somebody who's legit being like, I say that I have something wrong and then I think that the world's wrong. You're like, no, it's actually you messed up. I'm like, okay.
It's another perspective. It's another way to just bring you through an emotional journey and not tell you what's wrong with you. That's not the point of therapy, and that's not what BetterHelp does, okay? It's not a crisis line. It's not a self-help. It's a professional therapy done securely online. Dude, the pandemic hit, and I was like, oh, I'm going to hate doing therapy over FaceTime. Let me tell you something. It really changed the game, dude, because you can do therapy from the comfort of your own home. It's really incredible. I love it. And then BetterHelp, the service is available for clients worldwide. You can log into your account at any time and send a message to your therapist, okay? You'll get timely and thoughtful response. Plus, you can schedule weekly video or phone sessions so you won't ever have to sit in an uncomfortable waiting room as with traditional therapy, okay?
So if you want to seek any attention and start talking to somebody under 48 hours today, here's what you do. You go to betterhelp.com/socks. That's BetterHelp, H-E-L-P, and join the one over... And join over the 1 million people who have taken charge of their mental health with the help of an experienced professional. And since you do listen to the show and you are kind enough to not skip through the ad reads, we have a special promo code for you. Okay?
Give it to them, Trev. Give it to them.
10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/socks. Goddamn.
So what was the, I know these are interview questions, but I literally don't know. So what, were you making videos in Marietta and you're like, fuck it, let's go to LA? Or you were just like, oh, I just need to get out of here. Let me go to LA to like, why'd you come to LA? I guess is my question. Was it like acting or some shit? Or you,
yeah,
or you
me just wanted and Spence, to get out? Or first I like moved to Long Beach. I was like, I got to get out of Marietta. And then like moved to Long Beach with some friends and with Spencer, who I live with now still. And then, yeah, then we were just like, let's fuck around and make videos. And they were like the worst videos in the world. Yeah. Still are, bitch.
Wasn't it a prank channel? Didn't you take over a prank channel?
And then
you
we took over a prank channel called Simple Misfits.
And they were big, yeah?
It was like 400K. And like at the time, I was like,
400K, the pie is like, am I on MTV, dude, every day, dude?
Yeah.
That's a lot of people. That's when, like, when was that? What year do you think?
2000 and like... 15, 16.
Yeah, dude, that's when, like, I remember watching YouTube in college a lot, and, like, pranks were massive.
Yeah, pranks
that dude,
were a Fousey, thing.
FouseyTube was, like, he would get, like, 30 million views a video.
Yeah, just, like, what?
But he'd be, like, pranks, where it's, like,
I don't know what
yelling at somebody
are...
in an elevator, and then you get the GoPro footage.
Yeah. Dressing a kid up as a homeless guy, and, like...
Dude, all the... There was...
And just funny! Putting in the reactions of people that's, like, walking past him.
Yeah. Funny!
Then there's a weird... It's so biased. There was a weird era of, like, social experiments.
Yeah.
There'd be, like...
Like what?
It would be, like, weird stuff, where it'd be, like, I dressed up as a homeless man, and then somebody gave me $20, and then I looked at them and I said... If I wasn't homeless, would you give me this money?
Yeah.
And they would like
what?
Yeah. Or they would, dude, this guy Joey Salads, probably the.
Do you remember him?
Dude, this guy literally would be like, he would like fake kidnap kids, social experiment.
Yeah, and then make the world look horrible.
Yeah, and then like a paid actor would like kidnap the kid, and then he'd be like, "This is what's wrong with society." I was like, "No, what's wrong with society is you paid this guy $27 to come fake kidnap a kid and give him a Jamba Juice smoothie afterwards."
Didn't Joey Salad show his cock?
He peed in his mouth.
In his own mouth?
He peed in his mouth.
I remember,
I don't know how, but like all of his comments to this day. And then he like tried to run for like senator or president or something.
Yeah, he ran for Congress in 2019.
Oh my gosh.
That's the life of a YouTuber. You either go into boxing afterwards or you pee in your mouth and run for Congress.
Yeah, and I think he got like, I think someone took a video of him like directing a social experiment where like he got like, he went to the hood.
All fake.
Yeah, and then
that
like
was a big
people.
Era too. That was just like blatant racism. They're like, they're like bringing a gun.
Yeah.
They're like, white guy brings a gun to the hood.
Yeah, it's
you
like,
won't believe the results. I feel like I know the results.
Yeah,
you're gonna get your ass beat.
Respectfully.
Do you remember this dude? And this is more recent than Salas. But like, do you remember the dude that would like might be on TikTok where he would go around to the hood and the dudes would have like their pants like lower, and he would go around and be like, oh, yeah, pull your pants up, and pull the pants up.
I think that was an old thing, but they just re-uploaded. I remember that too.
Oh, they're called like, there was one time a gun fell out, like it was fucking wild.
OCTV, I think is what they're called.
Dude, those guys,
it's all like, those, what? And they would just get punched every time. It's like, yeah, because right, you look like you're about to like steal their wallet and shit.
What's crazy is this was the prime age of YouTube. So if a video got like 30 million views, that's like a mortgage on a house for you.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Like these prank dudes rack the fuck out off early YouTube.
Can you want me to? I don't know shit about YouTube. I know the money used to be crazy, and now it's like fine. But what is that? What is like a million views when it used to be nuts?
I don't know.
I don't know what it used to be, but like, this guy that are at All Def Digital that used to like manage, like, dude, he was pulling in like $70,000 a month on
just managing.
What? No, his channel was.
Oh,
but all of his was clickbait to be like, pregnancy scare with my girlfriend, and they're both looking at the camera like, zoinks, Scoob. That's what I hear every time I see a thumbnail. But zoinks.
Yeah.
But I don't know. This,
every time they're making this face.
Yeah.
Like you're like,
zoinky, Scooby. Yeah.
But from what I heard, I don't know if this is true or not, but there was a was it PewDiePie who had, he had a video that said something, something happened where a big like Ford or somewhere and advertised on a video
of YouTube because of like a anti-Semitic joke or something about that.
Yeah, I don't know, but essentially something like that happened. Then YouTube is like cracks down so hard on everything now. You have to like snitch on yourself when you upload a video. Be like, is there cussing? Is there nudity? At what level? Is it brief level? Is there how much areola is shown?
I put none of the above on all of them. And
really?
Like, yeah.
I snitch a little. I'll be like, there's a few cuss words.
Because then you're just thinking of like the person being like, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you do none.
Just a robot.
Your thumbnail is literally just tits taking up the whole screen. You're like, none.
No. My last one had a butt like way far in the background, but they just took down the thumbnail and they're like, we're not going to give you a strike. And I'm like, thanks.
You guys. Oh, come on.
You guys. And I just re-uploaded.
I mean, they're horny too. At YouTube, they're like, yeah.
Yeah, they're like,
it is crazy what a thumbnail does for a video.
Yeah, what's up with that?
I mean, it's literally.
Some thumbnails I'm like, I can't pick a good thumbnail out of this video.
Yeah.
I wish I like cared.
Even if it's
more
unrelated, it's like you playing piano, but your thumbnail's just tits.
Yeah.
Shit, man. Should we fire off some questions people got? I don't really know. It's urges. I'm having a good time just talking.
I like talking. I don't fucking care about myself. Let's answer one
question. Whoa, dude.
Let me what was your first impression of me? Besides Scott's hot as fuck.
I was like, this guy's tall.
This guy's gonna drop me off a girl in like a year.
This guy's definitely gonna find me a girl and drop
me. Dude,
I'm
the best wingman ever. The most unintentional wingman ever.
Dude. Yeah. First thought of you. Wait, when was it?
Yeah, when
I think like
the first time
one of
we
us
ever
like,
met was at one of your shows you threw in downtown.
Yeah, and I was like so frazzled because I was like hosting them and they're like nuts. So I was like, "What's up, dude? You're fucking sexy." All right, I gotta go.
Yeah, it was,
I was
like a
dang,
warehouse.
Bro,
yeah.
You blow dry your hair? Fuck. And then I was like running.
Pussy.
I asked him like the other day. I was like, "How's your hair always so good? Because mine looks like shit balls." And he's like, "I blow dry it." And I was like, I want to be you, bro.
Dude, if you took a blow dryer to your hair and put like a little bit of product, your shit would be fucking sick.
I should.
Like,
dude, let's do it live now. Gabe, let's where's shampoo? Yeah. This is an intervention for your hair,
dude. I shampoo it.
It just gets freaky.
Bro, you're like a girl in like an early 90s movie where all you do is take the glasses off and do your hair. And it's like, oh my God, the nerd turns
what?
It hot as fuck.
Wait, Mandy Moore was hot the whole time in a Walk to Remember?
I think your hair right now looks like Jeff Daniels in Dumb and Dumber. Is that fucked up 100%. To say? Is that mean?
No, I want it to start looking like the fucking Lord of the Rings. It does. No! That's why I wear a hat. I try to tame the beast.
Dude, bro, you have money. Let's go to a fucking Grand Clips.
I don't know what to do. My mom's been cutting my hair since I was a baby. And I'm like, what do I do now?
Isn't that crazy?
And then like, I'm like, Jeff, do you want to, can I come to your barbershop, bro?
He's like, bro, literally go anywhere.
Yeah, go anywhere.
Go to a fucking, dude.
There's probably one right across the street for me.
I mean, it's LA. You just yell out the window, I need a barber.
The thing I'm wanting to do is like cut it for a video. Like people be like, whoa, he cut his hair like on camera. It's like,
why? So you can write it off for your taxes? Dude, that's, I made a video I thought was gonna, I'll ask you this question a sec too. I made a video I thought was gonna hit about like when dudes get a headboard, because I thought dudes thought that was a flex. And then the first comment was like, did you do this? You just write off your headboard?
Oh, yeah. Taxes? That's like the top comment.
And I was like, what the fuck?
I almost commented that. I was like, someone did that. Yeah.
Yeah. And now I got to think about that. I was like, and then same with the air fry. I did an air fry video. I was like, is this a tax write off? I was like,
yes.
True. Yeah. I'm writing off $40, guys.
Well, also, the fucking air fryer is a tax write off, even if you don't put it in a video.
Really?
Yeah.
Tax,
yeah,
I don't understand how tax. I mean, I can't say that.
You go, you go like this. You're on a business call while making chicken. Tax write-off.
Booyah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's all done.
I buy a bunch of snacks at like 7-Eleven to watch a movie, and I'm like, I need inspiration. I'm using this as inspiration for my videos. Boom, tax write-off.
IRS is listening right now. They're like, that's interesting. Yeah. Dude, your snack haul is wild.
It's wild, yeah.
Did you see somebody post on his Instagram? It's like the cold nacho cheese, sour punch kid straws, whatever the fuck. Sunflower seeds and like a diet Dr. Pepper.
Yeah, I remember one time I was like, I have a problem. Was when you like, we're about to film and I was like waiting for you out front and you're like, I could tell this was you because there's a pound of like spit out sunflower seeds out of your car. I'm like, I'm disgusting. There's no wonder why I don't have a girlfriend.
I don't spit them out.
You just chew them?
Really?
Like a fucking psycho.
Do they come out of your ass just like in seed form? Like it looks like horse shit.
But I like it because it kind of hits my...
It cleans it out. Yeah. I see.
You eat the whole thing? I don't want.
Yeah, like a crazy. I honestly.
So you just throw a handful in and just
go. Like, yeah, I didn't have a dad, dude. No one taught me how to fucking do anything, dude. You know what I mean?
That is true.
That is true.
But yeah, you look like a fucking demon, dude.
I'll be your dad. I'll teach you.
Dude, teach me, man. Yeah. I'm telling you, you have dad vibes. Like it's like I think you. I think you'd be a great father.
Did you? Hell yeah. Your dad character.
We're gonna raise a dad together.
Raising a dad at age 40, you're like, we're going to the park. And he's like, I can drive myself there. Shut up, get in the back, get your booster seat.
I have a 401k, bitch.
I'm going to raise a dad.
That was a video idea I had where it's like some babysitter comes over. They're like, oh, yeah, where's your kid? Like, you're babysitting me, buddy.
Yeah, I'm just lonely.
Goo goo gaga. Does it matter?
Goo goo gaga. I'm lonely. Let's watch Homeward Bound. What's a video you thought was gonna smash, like be like, this is a hit, and then didn't? And then vice versa. What's a video that hit? You're like, really? This is what y'all want?
Yeah, that always happens. And then like if I think it's not gonna hit and it hits, I'm like, I knew that shit.
I'm a genius.
I'm a genius.
It's always like the more you think about it, the more you're like, this is gonna hit. That's why I'm nervous for this ice cream one. I'm like, this one is so funny.
Yeah.
And then the internet's like, we'll see about that.
Yeah, we'll see about that. Dude, like, probably are like, is it chill if I chill here? We're making it because it was so like different
for you didn't think it'd hit or you did think it.
I like didn't. Well, like, I was like, this is just a fun video.
Yeah.
And I was like, it's. And then I remember like a friend was like, no, this is really funny. I was like, okay. Yeah, that was our first video.
And I remember leaving that day and being like, what the fuck just happened?
Because like, yeah, we had like the guy that uses memes.
Footage. Yeah,
and then it turned into like this being a thing and like the grandma thing.
Is she resting in peace?
Yeah, she resting in peace. And like that became a meme. Like,
I remember leaving being like, how the fuck's he going to edit that?
Yeah.
It was like, we're filming for like 2 hours. It's just like, okay, you do this, you do that.
Yeah, just switching off and then like. And then, yeah, I was editing. I was like, this is so bizarre. Like, we're breaking the fourth wall. Like, he's just talking to me from far away for no reason.
Yeah.
And, like, it just, like, made no sense. And I was like, it's funny, though. And, like, someone was like, a friend watched it, and they're like, this is really funny. I'm like, okay. And, like, I posted it. It was doing fine. And then all of a sudden, like, Reddit took it.
Yeah.
And it was just like, here you go.
There was, like, this one-minute clip of just, like, the...
Yeah.
So what's up? What's good?
So you're comparing it to like a motorcycle.
Yeah.
And in the moment, we were just like, this is leading to the next part. We didn't think like that was like the funny part.
That's what's interesting about video is like, we could have thought that like maybe the meme part at the end was the funniest, but the internet decides what's the funniest part.
Yeah.
And
that's what's
same with like our lawn duty one, like lawn duty, Judge Judy.
Yeah.
Is there a line in any of yours that's just like, how did that become a thing?
I mean, honestly, ain't no laws when you're drinking claws.
Yeah,
it literally just rhymed.
Yeah, you're just I remember the internet was like, yes!
And that was at your apartment because I was still, again, living in my parents' house. It's not funny, during my fucking best video days was just at home crushing PB&Js my mom was making me. My mom's like, why'd you move back for the month? And I'm like, it's for the creative process. You know how Kanye like won't leave the Atlanta, the stadium?
Yeah.
I just go to my parents' house until I have the new white claws. club video. Like, this is my Atlanta stadium.
Yeah, I remember you guys filming that. And then now I just go to like a college campus and just hear from a distance, "Ain't no law."
Yeah, dude, I know.
I'm like, what, dude?
Yeah, but I remember I was just on your balcony. Ryan was across the apartment complex. And I was like, clause, what rhymes with clause? Clause, clause, laws, laws. Ain't no laws.
Yeah.
And then I just said it. And then the internet was like,
that. Yes.
Ada bing, dada boom.
You never really know.
We're going to make signs.
So what's a video you're like, this is going to be a hit? And I think I know what it is. Or it doesn't have, I don't have to be in it. Even though that's the only videos of yours I watched it.
I don't even know.
Chad's like, he'll like tell me a video and be like, not that you watched it because you weren't in it. Like,
how'd you know?
Right. You're right.
Yeah, I didn't know.
He's fucking right. You suck, dude. Bitch. Fuck you.
Can you hear me?
Which one? Yes, definitely Swan Duty.
Swan Duty. We rented swans on the fucking Silver Lake.
This is
Lake.
Genius.
Is that Silver Lake?
Has to be right. Echo Park.
Echo Park.
Right by Silver Lake. We're like,
rented swans, and we like had Ryan jump swan to swan with a.
We're working hard.
$10,000 camera in the water, and it just didn't hit.
Oh my gosh.
Hold on. So. They let Ryan jump from fucking swans.
I mean, yeah, we kind of.
They didn't know what the hell was going on.
Yeah, we're like, we just didn't say anything. You always got to ask for forgiveness and not permission. Because once you'd be like, can we film this? Yeah. Like,
well, also, the second you say film in Los Angeles, they think like, oh, do you need a permit? $10,000, you can do all this. So
we're literally just sitting there. Just like,
yeah, but it was so funny because we were like changing into our outfits in the lobby of this. Of this boat place.
Shop, boat place.
And we're all like putting our like mics on each other, like our wireless microphones.
They're
and
just
they're like,
huh?
And then once you're out in the lake, what are they going to do? Yell?
Yeah.
Yeah, what is it? They're coming with the fucking swan. Like, hey, stop it.
You can't do that.
I'm interfering.
That would just
this.
Make for a better video.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Didn't hit?
I think it did cool, but we were like, this is going to break the internet.
It's going to be 20 million, no problem.
Yeah, this is going to be our super bad. This is the one.
Right.
Yeah.
And then we put it out, and the world's like,
I have ones that like I'll put so much time and effort into.
Yeah.
I just call them passion projects, but I really want them to do well.
But when a passion project does well, that's like, the greatest feeling ever.
Like when we went to Elsinore, that one was, I was like, oh, this is a weird 20-minute video. And then it did pretty well. And I was like, yes.
I felt that way with about like the porn actor wants to be a real actor with Julia Rose. And then also when we went to Palm Springs,
the
bang bus one was great, but the Palm Springs one where I did like the reality show about not jerking off. I was like, there's a bunch of people in this could be funny, let's shoot it. Like
the
reality
was like really good
editing was crazy,
but that was one of those where I was like, I don't even care if this doesn't do great, like this is just a funny concept to me. But it is important to have. But when those do well, you're like, I am all that is man. Internet,
right?
Bow down to
it. It's like not relatable.
Fuck you, dude.
But it does reassure that, you know, you're like, it's like also like if you have a crazy belief on stand up on stage and you say something that's like unheard, but like super true to you. Like the fact that you can get people on board that you have a foot fetish in front of 300 people every night.
Yeah.
And they're like, we're in, is crazy.
Yeah.
It's insane.
Have you done that?
Oh, yeah.
This boy got a big foot fetish.
Do you really?
Oh,
nice. Okay.
Yeah.
You might want to tighten those straps, boy.
Johnny Bravo.
Dude, that was literally me when I had my hair bleached.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, you might want to tighten those straps before Blau be acting up over here.
You got to tighten these.
Boy,
straps.
I got.
Just put 2 inches on me, bro. I'm gonna be as tall as you.
Oh shit, I need that.
I
need that, dude.
You got any? You got any fetishes, dude? Besides,
that's where
I'm
going.
They just choke you with a Slim Jim.
Just Mormon fetishes. Mormon
fetishes. Yeah. So wait, at what point were you just like, Mormon, y'all be left on scene. I'm out. Because his family's all Mormon.
I do leave the sister missionaries.
Huh?
Yeah.
His fetish is caffeine is fucking.
It is, bro. It is.
Carbonation.
Dude, like, I've been trying to go sober, and like, I'm just like 5 coffees a day.
Oh, yeah.
It's the Man, only thing that brings me joy. I'm like Skittles.
Bro, I feel you. There's nothing else to do.
So caffeine, I'm like, snort it.
So you were Mormon your whole life?
Yeah.
Like heavy Mormon.
Uh-huh.
Like fucking Mormon.
Balls deep, baby.
Wow. And then
weird thing to say, you're balls deep Mormon.
At what age were you like,
we gotta film at a Mormon church.
I want to not be balls deep. This is ludicrous.
And like when I like moved out, and then now I'm like, dude, I'm going back.
Well, y'all accept me still. I brought a helmet.
I go to an LA party. People are snorting coke off like the ground. I'm like, I'm going back.
They're saying, I'm going home, dude.
I'm going home, dude.
I need a helmet and
y'all
a bike.
Y'all crazy.
In a black tie, bro. And they don't fucking throw
What was your first step out? Was it something small like drinking a carbonated soda?
Yeah.
Or were you like, I had a foursome?
I literally, like, I moved out and then I drank and smoked and then had sex for, in like, the same first night? Time. No, that would be funny. In like the in the same like month though, oh, I was like, whoa, what's this shit?
What the fuck? Well, didn't we discover that Amish people do? They have like a week or a month where
yeah,
they
it's a rum
year. Yeah,
they have a year where they dip and they go like live the craziest life they can. Then
oh
come
yeah,
back.
And then they have the choice to come back.
Dude, that is.
What it's called.
I wish we would have done that and just been like, that was crazy.
I mean, that's essentially what college is. If you're not.
Yeah.
You go for true. 4 years. You fuck your life up, you snort Adderall off a girl's forehead.
Herpes.
Well,
whoa,
guys,
you find out that you have a foot fetish.
I knew early.
That was middle school, anyways.
Have you guys talked about the foot fetish a lot?
It's
a
running theme.
It is.
I won't ask questions then.
By all means,
you can ask.
He's very
I'm an open.
I bet every question has been asked.
Would you want to?
I'm all for it,
dude. So, Donald, do you have any kinks? We're gonna get back. We're gonna get back to the Mormon thread. It's interested if you have any like
Mormon kinks.
Not Mormon kinks.
Mormon kinks. She puts that bike head on my church. Dick.
I got Mormon kinks. We need to do a Mormon video. I did a Mormon video in Utah where we were Mormon missionaries. Dude, we would be the best Mormon missionaries. Yeah, you weren't in it. No. It would have got 50 billion views.
Dude, and I'm Jewish. Fuck.
Uh-oh. I don't think I have any fetish. I'm pretty like vanilla.
Really?
Yeah, I'm just like,
there's no way.
I'm like, let's stare into each other's eyes, yeah, not each other's feet.
You be low-key getting hoes.
Pussy.
Not anymore, dude. I'm scared of girls, bro. I'm trying to get a wife now. My Mormonism's coming back. I want kids, bro. Yo, if you're ready to settle, let's wrestle.
Bro, I was the same way, man. You've been in the streets long enough. You're like, can I just love somebody?
Yeah, can I just...
like, can I just... I want to make...
There's a girl blasting Diplo at 7 a.m. in your room, and you're like, I don't need this.
Yeah. It's like, I just want to make a pumpkin pie with someone. Like, can I just do that?
Yeah, I want to put the pumpkin pie by the window, let it cool off. Like,
yeah,
a fucking grandma.
You ever try to be, like, too cutesy with a girl who's clearly like on a one night stand with you? She's like,
and they're like, what?
She's like, Chad, you know what this is, right? And you're like, I just wanted to do jump rope.
I had that before. I was like drunk and like this girl like was like, all right, like I gotta sleep, like you gotta go. I was like, are you being a fuck boy right now? I wanted to cuddle.
Yeah.
She's like, you got like, I got work in the morning. I'm like, I bet.
But I got work right now. You can work on this heart, baby girl.
Bet. You've been working hard on this heart.
You guys are the captains of, you know, not as much anymore, I think, but you guys are like, I'm gonna fly some people out. Y'all both be on that fly them out shit.
Yeah, I don't know if I could.
Yeah, but I don't pay for the ticket though.
Oh, okay.
I was like, okay, noted. I'll write that down.
If they catch me in a manic state and they flirt with me for 1 second, I'm like, we're getting married, right? Like, yeah, fly me out in LA. And I'm like, okay, I've done it like a few times. I probably won't do it anymore.
How many
unless
times?
Like I find my wife, and then I think about it. I'm like, I'm looking at like, it's like $100-$200 plane ticket. I'm like, that's like a nice meal.
Yeah.
Like a nice meal, nice night out.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's also
or less. And then it's like, they're like,
not going to be your wife.
They're not going to be your wife.
They live in fucking Liberty Township.
Michigan. They're always from Michigan.
Your goddamn wife.
Dude, it's
they
random.
Are, bro.
But it's Michigan, but their Instagram bio says LA in it. And you're like,
yeah, it's Michigan to LA. And they're like, I'm in
Tennessee. She's like, you think I'm just visiting you? You're like, oh, no.
Oh, fuck, no.
Do you want me to drop you off at my friend Chad's house again?
But, dude, we talk about this all the time. If you're in a weird city flying to LA, you know exactly who's getting flown out.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're
always wearing neon, sitting in first class.
Yeah.
And headphones on, acting like they're not there. It's like, you know who's getting flown out.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, you weren't gonna bet in Jerry's.
I've never flown first class. It's like $3,000 more. I'm like, what? Why isn't it just like $100 more?
Sometimes it is. Like, to Salt Lake, it's like $100 more.
Okay.
But then you're like, okay, do buddy. I really want to fly to Salt Lake? Being like, yeah, give me my own.
An hour.
Yeah, exactly.
I remember like a fan came up to me and I was like in the back. And I was like, I was like, squish. I'm like, what's up, bro? I'm saving money here. He's like, all right, I'll see you in a fucking, what's it called? I don't even know the names of the bad ones.
Economy?
Plus?
Yeah, Economy Plus.
Yeah, one time I was editing like, my video next to a guy and he goes like, I thought it would be like a much bigger like production. I was like, just me on iMovie and Economy being like,
yeah. I can't believe you use iMovie for
no,
so long.
No, I don't anymore. Now
no,
Final
I know,
Cut.
But you used it for so long. It's crazy.
Premier,
I mean,
it's
dummy
boy.
Proof. It's like literally playing Tetris with three blocks. You're like, this goes here, that go there.
Yeah.
But like my
Deco
biggest videos there. Were on iMovie, so I was like, if it ain't broke, don't
super,
fix it.
Super superstitious.
Yeah, exactly.
iMovie bangers.
iMovie, blonde hair, live at home. That's the key to success.
If I get money from my broken leg getting hit by a car, let's make a movie.
Yeah, how we need to talk about
yeah,
that. Because I don't even know
open with this, dude.
So I heard from I don't even know if I heard from you. I just saw, like, you, all of a sudden you were, like, posting about, like...
You didn't even visit me in the hospital.
I was out of town, dog.
Just kidding. I know.
Dude, I visited.
That would have been funny, dude. Yeah, I did.
Can you imagine?
The girl that left me to bed, you even visited.
You just visited me because you knew my feet would be out, bro.
Yo, I sucked on
my feet were propped up.
I was like, oh, I know you can't wash your toes because you're, like, you know, like, on the stretcher. I got you.
That's how I like it. Yeah, I got you,
my
bro.
My tongue's a loofah, bro.
Nurse is like, what are you doing in here? You're like, I got it.
Yeah.
What were we talking about? Oh, so yeah, I just remember you were like posting your story like eating Funyuns, and then the next slide. The next slide was just you. The next slide was just you in the hospital being like, I thought it was like, is this for a sketch? Is this
broken
a
leg? Suck my
keg, dick, choke, dig. Big cock.
I can't
and I was
rhyme
like, are you
like
good?
You.
And then I had called Ryan because I called you and you needed an answer. And I was like, yeah, apparently you got hit by
morphine.
A car.
Yeah. So yeah, I was making jokes right when I got out of surgery.
You filmed the sketch in the hospital. That's the best location scout ever.
Yeah, I know. I was like, production value. Yeah, bingo. Dude.
But that's how our brains work. It's like, I'm going to a wedding this weekend, and the whole time I'm there, I'm like, what can I film when I'm there? What can I do when I'm here? You know?
Planning your planning your best man speech.
When you bang the groomsman, cut it.
You could do like best man speech preparation.
No, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the guy who didn't get a plus one to a wedding.
Oh, yeah.
Because I feel like they're always over talking and they always like think that they had chemistry with the girl getting married. Like, yeah, me and Juliana, like, I feel like I actually introduced her to Travis. So, like, it's whatever. You know, I don't. And then they're always being like, so what did the girls up there are like, what are those called? The best woman? Whatever. Are they down? Are any of them single? They're always trying to be like, who's single? And you're like, why would we know?
Yeah.
We're their Texans. We're from Texas. We don't know these people.
We don't know you.
Also, every single dude always thinks like the women, whatever the fuck, what are they called?
Bridesmaids.
Thank you. Bridesmaids are all whores. They're all super nice.
Like, are they going to fuck in the janitor's closet with
you?
Yeah,
exactly. They're like, oh, because you're single and I'm single. We're a match now. It's like, this isn't The Bachelorette.
They see that in the, yeah. I walked you down the aisle. We touched fucking arms. Yeah. Let's touch dicks.
But that's how the guy's brain works, where you're like, I can fuck.
Yeah.
The weddings lube a woman up, though. It is insane. They see
like,
love. And they're like, I'm wet.
Yeah.
It's very interesting.
Up there. We should watch some of my wedding videos and cry.
Let's do it, dude. Speaking of crying, can we please? I haven't heard this story.
Okay.
So for people that don't know, you please.
I got hit by a car while I was riding an e-bike. It's classic.
This sounds like a Pornhub title. Yeah. E-bike gets smashed by Ford F-350.
Step bro.
And oh, no, like, step bro, I'm caught into the fender.
The funny part is I
fender?
Rode.
Fender?
I fixed.
Cars have fenders?
Fenders.
That's
fenders.
A guitar.
And then it goes into a State Farm ad.
Wait, do cars have fenders? Insurance. Cars have fenders. No?
Yes,
cars
have bumpers, fenders.
Okay. Oh, fenders are
I
in the
fender
front?
I thought
fender
was a guitar.
Fender's the front, fender's a guitar. Bumper's the back.
I went to a state school.
It is a guitar Dang. Also.
It is also a guitar, yeah.
So you got hit by a car on a
Why don't
e-bike?
People call asses bumpers?
I got hit by a Gibson Les Paul.
Whoa.
What are you saying to me?
Because a fender gets.
Got it. I missed it. I'm sorry.
Booyah!
I was like, my Mormon dad saw me drinking his decaf and he beat my ass one day. Anyways.
And then I got hit.
You jumped a few steps. Yeah, you're on an e-bike.
Give me some details.
On an e-bike. And I was going across a crosswalk and then a car just comes flying out of nowhere and hits this leg.
Oh,
and then,
fuck.
And then the bike's on the ground. The guy almost tried. We have it all on camera because there's like security.
Oh, my God. Do you have the footage?
Yeah.
Can I see it?
Dude, talk about a viral video, bro.
I know.
Dude,
I guess that
would have done more numbers than Swan Duty. I'll tell you what. Dude.
Yeah, right? And then let's find it here. Oh, Ryan's texting me.
He heard it.
How did he hear
fucking
it?
Fucking Ryan knows we're
bro,
together.
Bro, can we put this footage on the fucking podcast?
Of you getting hit?
Here, I'll show you. I think so. Maybe. I put it in Jeff's podcast. So, fast forward just a little bit real quick. I fixed the bike after, like, with my fucking brace on. I fixed the bike. The truck got more damage, I think. And then I rode it to Jeff's podcast to talk about it.
It was your e-bike. You rode that bike again?
And I was like, fuck, I'm gonna die.
That's like getting bit by a shark and you're like, I'm getting back in that water on Tuesday. I'm
getting back in that water.
What type of car or truck was it that hit you?
Dang, we're cute, bro.
Dang, that do be me.
It was, I don't know, but...
Was it a truck or a car?
Here, I'll show you guys. You guys could just like react to it. It was a car.
Did they
and then
slam
the
on
guy,
the brakes?
And then yeah, he slammed
He's
on the
like,
brakes. I got hit. Yeah,
Trevor Walsh.
And then the dude.
No, it's actually the other guy. And so it's not a group. You're like, what? Just hit me.
Hit me. And then And then he got out and he starts yelling at me.
Of course.
Like while I'm on the ground.
I think anybody would instinctually do that.
Yeah. And I'm like, why are you? I'm on the ground. Like my leg's bleeding. It's like twisted. I'm
No.
I'm like, bruh. And then here's the clip of the guy hitting me.
Oh my God. Wait, go back. God damn.
That's me sleeping, okay? Because I have purple mattress for you. Doesn't it seem like the world's against you from getting a good night's sleep this time of year? Okay, but when you have a purple mattress, you get sleep cool and comfortable no matter what the world throws at you. That's because only purple mattresses have the grid. It's unique.
The Grinch. That doesn't apply here.
It doesn't, but I love that movie. It's a unique ventilated design, allows air to flow through to help you sleep cool, not hot, cool, even when it feels like 1,000 degrees out. And the grid is amazing, supportive for your back and legs while cushioning your shoulders, neck, and hips, no matter how you sleep.
Unlike memory foam, which remembers everything.
Weird.
Everything. Everything. My ex used to sleep here for 2 years, and now I gotta look over and see her indent there, and I gotta cry every night and fill it up with a bag of Funyuns.
Funyuns?
Too specific.
Maybe.
Anyways, you need the grid, okay? Look, they sent me a pillow, and it's like, I feel like this is a pillow that'll last. Built tough. It's a sturdy pillow. If you have a pillow fight with that, you're knocking out a four-year-old. You shouldn't do that. That's very illegal. But it's a comfortable pillow and it's cool. I feel like when I lay my head in it, the grid almost like pushes a little bit of air out. So it's like free air conditioning.
Let me tell you something. If you're single and you ain't got nobody to hug you, get a purple pillow. That shit'll hug your goddamn head. Yeah. Holy shit. It'll hug your head while you're getting head. Guys, all right. Purple is comfort reinvented. Right now, you get 10% off any order at $200 or more. How much? 10% off any order at $200 or more. Go to purple.com/socks and use promo code socks. That is purple.com/socks, promo code socks for 10% off any order of $200 or more. Purple.com/socks, promo code socks.
Terms apply.
They do. They apply. God damn.
Do your best Trevor Wallace impersonation.
What the fuck?
Why do I sound
like... Dude!
Why do I just sound like a guy that hangs out in a subway? Oh, pirate laugh?
Dude!
Dude, when people... What?
I said that was pretty good.
It's pretty good.
You got a Cherdleys impression?
Give it.
Yeah. What is... Like, dude. What do you even do?
Dude, my brain hurts.
Dude, life's a joke. Where's the coke? There's a period where we said that when we weren't even doing coke. Just be like, where's the coke?
Dude, just anything that rhymes. Telling a joke, who got the coke?
Who got the coke?
Anything that rhymes is very on brand.
That rhymes
let's just rapid fire through these questions some people wrote in.
Yeah, we're going to do it for Sock Talk today where people write in asking for advice and questions for the guys. We asked for some specifically
for the boys. Because
Charlie's going to be here. So we got some questions. We're just going to go through them quick. First question is, Chad, who do you think is smarter in real life, you or Trevor?
Trevor, dude, I got a brain of a fucking moron.
Dude, no,
that didn't
no
even
fight.
Make sense.
Brain of a moron?
Brain of a moron.
I thought you were going to say Mormon, which would make
brain of a
way
Mormon
more sense.
And a moron.
Book of Mormon, that's a thing.
I feel like my brain doesn't work very fast. Like, I feel like yours and like Spencer's does. That's why Spencer's just like
Spencer's
like does
really
these
funny
rants,
just
and I'm like what
just
the
riffing.
Fuck yeah
yeah
Sir Spencer who
he
played that
like,
Seth character when we were in
oh,
the
yeah,
beach
yeah,
he's like
and he, yeah yeah
yeah he also like never misses up like a take like he just does first take just like a 30-second rant and I'm like
yeah
not one word will stumble
yeah I'm like what the and he like does rap battles sometimes like as a joke and really? I'm like
very funny
that was
Spencer.
So good
right
cool all right next question what's the best and worst surface to have sex on?
I had sex on my roof and like, and with my broken ass leg.
How the fuck did you get up there with a broken leg?
Dude, the first day I got back from the hospital, I pulled myself up the ladder and like, was like, and like, it was for 4th of July. I got back and I was like, fuck. And I was like, I don't know how I'm getting down. I literally had to like pull myself up. I was like, dang, I'm fucking strong.
Dude, so when women say they're more horny than dudes, lies. You what? Had a broken
what
ass.
What girl
dick.
Says that?
Dude, all girls are like, no, we're horny too. It's like, no, you're not as horny.
No, no,
you
I wasn't going up. That leg. Was just to see fireworks. But I
loser.
Did go back up.
I thought you then were the fucking second, with the fireworks.
And then the
you
other, too. That would
coming
be sick.
Coming at the same time as fireworks? Freaking great.
That would have been sick. Has that ever happened?
Yes.
It could happen right now. That's Gabe, nice. Cut off the lights.
The worst place... Yeah, on the roof hurt, like, gave her, like, a bruise back here, and, like, my leg was like, ah, oh, fuck, and, like, my knees. And then the most epic place was at Coachella on the Ferris wheel.
On the
no.
Ferris wheel?
No,
wait,
that wasn't the most epic, but that was pretty epic.
On the Ferris wheel?
Yeah, because you get your own, like, thing, and yeah. I was, and every time, like, we would come down, we'd be like, all right.
Chill. Dude, that it's so funny. We were just talking about if you jerked off on a Ferris wheel. How, like, at what angle can you start getting back into it? Because once you get low, you got to be like, chill. You're like, oh, whoa, they have corn dogs over there.
Yeah.
But then the second you leave, like,
deep fried
10
Oreos.
Foot in the air, you're like, pull that dick
you're like,
out.
What the fuck? There's kids everywhere. Wow.
Right? That's so funny. Also, there's people above you who can just be like, guys.
Yeah, we're so hammered.
Oh, the pods, I think they're different. Wow. I bet a lot of people fuck there.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
The worst place.
I got sucked off on those swans that we filmed Swan Duty on.
No way. Yeah. After the fact? Or after we
you
filmed?
You remember, dude? It was me and you, dog.
Shush up, dude.
No, I went back with a lady. Me and the girlfriend went on a date there. And it was like nighttime. And she's like, do you want... It was funny because I was the bitch in the situation. I was nervous. I was like, what if people see?
There's lights like yeah, on the thing.
Yeah,
so that means like
thought.
Someone from a mile away is like,
that's
what?
What I thought. And that's what I was telling her. I was like, you don't think people can see from the land? But it turns out the
for
lights
sure.
Almost like... blow it out
okay.
So you can't see inside.
Overexposed blow job.
Overexposed, you looked,
blown
when
out
you got
blow
back
out.
You were like yeah you were
but that's
blown
the thing.
Out
once
and
I got
blown
back
out.
I saw you couldn't see what was going on. I was like, damn, I could have.
Did you nut and you were just like ah
no.
I was getting a massage yesterday and I was
yes.
Like but I've never got one of those happy endings. I'd probably feel too bad. I'll be like, no, stop, I'm saving myself for Trevor. And then but I'm like, what, like what those places that do is like some guys are probably fucking loud and they're like ah ah. Like an old guy that doesn't give a fuck. He's just like, I'm like, everyone knows.
Yeah. Dude, I
yeah, but that's
happy,
how you
ain't?
Choose which masseuse to go to, whoever's the loudest
right.
Guy. You
yeah,
go, okay,
yeah.
The
that
middle
one. Yeah, if you guys see a guy come out of there straight yeah. Face, no moan, you're like, I don't need her.
Yeah,
yeah.
You
if he
be
comes
like,
out like wobbling.
Oh, yeah,
like,
if he can't
woo!
Even walk, you're like, he got the soul sucked out of him. You know?
Yeah. That guy looks like Jello. I'm going in there, bro.
Yeah, I'm going in there.
The Holy Spirit of nut. All right, that's pretty epic.
I love it.
Pretty epic. Who do you think would win in a bare knuckle boxing fight?
Something about bare knuckles yeah. Is
so
funny. So
funny.
It's like you really have three? To be mad at somebody yeah. In a bare knuckle.
Bare knuckle fight. I don't know. I feel like I feel like you have some like secret. Some secret.
Oh,
look at those knuckles. Wait.
Yeah, Michael beat all of our asses.
Yeah, he probably would.
Dude,
you're lanky. You just
yeah,
like
my knuckles
reach.
Look like they're made out of sprees. Like,
I couldn't
can't.
Imagine Trevor fighting. Me, I would just cry and be like, yeah, wait, yeah, I can't.
What are you talking about, dude? The whole Kyle video, the whole idea, the whole thing we did at the Monster Headquarters, that's actually one of my favorite videos we did at
yeah.
The Monster Headquarters. Where
those
we're,
ones are funny.
We were talking into the cups and we're like fighting between the cubicles. Shut the fuck up.
Oh, no,
and I
funny.
Bleach hair.
Yeah,
Trevor,
I think
go
Michael.
Back.
What do you look like?
Michael's
in your shirt?
Jacked. It's like
really?
He's like he
yeah.
Like doesn't wear like clothes that show his jack.
Yeah, you guys both have like those chiseled jawlines.
Dude, you trying to fuck us right now?
I'm so horny, dude.
I would definitely be, dude. I'm
so horny
I'm
for my boys.
Horned up. Okay, my girl's
monster's
been
got me horny.
My girl's been
but
going.
You guys
for
both
two
got girlfriends?
Weeks. Yeah, dude.
Fuck,
his girlfriend's
bro.
Been out of town for 2 weeks, so he's.
Dang.
I haven't
celibate.
Put my peepee in a vajayjay in 2 weeks. What the fuck, dude? You ever seen a lot of
here,
cum come out of
my hand,
cup?
Dude, use my toes. I know yeah. You want it.
Oh, dude, I will put my dick in between like your toe and your shoe. And
oh yeah, like right
in.
Here.
Yep.
Squirt.
Jail style. Let's go, dude.
this question is, what's the best sex position with a broken leg?
Any.
Dude, just reverse cowgirl. You're just like,
oh,
you're in pain,
the
and they're just like, they don't even look in you. You're like, ow, but it feels good.
Feels good,
oh,
but it hurts.
They can't
feels...
look at you. That's great.
Yeah, they suggested, they're like, come on, I'm gonna show you what I got now. And I've never had sex, though, dude. I'm lying through my teeth. I'm playing a character right now that has sex. The real me sucks.
What's your character? I pretend I'm not a virgin. That's why I drink Monster Energy drinks on podcasts.
God!
Yeah, do you ever do it?
Yeah, I had one this morning.
Oh, yeah.
Gabe? All right, let's do one more here. This is just, what's the character that you're most proud of?
My Trevor Wallace character.
Sounds like your dad wrote in. What's the character you're most proud of?
the comments like patting you on the back. Like, this is good.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe my dad character. It's just like
that one's very spot on.
So funny.
It's been around forever too. And it's just like ridiculous.
Was the first one you did the one at Coachella?
Yeah. Me and Spencer did one a long time ago, but it like was so bad. It was just me like being loud and like shaking hands. That was like the only character trait. It was like, yeah. Like, it doesn't even do that anymore. Or I guess we kind of do that unless I'm fun for. But just the frat ones are always fun.
Frat ones are great. Somebody yelling. You know, it's just like, we need more chaos.
I think we always play like two peas in a pod.
Yeah.
Like, we're always the first time
we ever filmed together, it just like, it did, the riff just worked.
Yeah.
Same with me and Michael when we met at a comedy show and we just talked like back and forth for like an hour.
Yeah.
Literally. And then a week later, he called me. He's like, hey, you ever thought of starting a podcast? And I was like, that's so crazy. I was thinking about that yesterday.
Yep. Yeah. That is crazy. Well, you guys were like, well, we were on coke the first time.
Yeah, it didn't help that we talked for 5 hours in front of a Babies R Us, but
I could tell off of it. But we were on Adderall.
Where did we met through Instagram DMs? Was that it?
Because I
was
working at All Dev. I think I slid in DMs.
Well, I remember the first time I saw your video was I was working at All Dev Digital and you were like selling your videos to them to like post for like a couple $100 or whatever.
Yeah.
And then I remember I was like, what the fuck, dude, this white dude's playing a frat guy. That's me, dog. I remember
but
you know, like how a lot of times the first time you meet somebody you don't like them because you feel like they're like intimidating or they're like doing something better than you.
The fuck you saying you didn't like me?
Because I was threatened, dude. I was like, wait, dude, I thought I was the only white dude on All That Digital that you guys are posting. Dude, who's this Chad guy?
I did think that too. I was like, whoa, I'm like the fucking weird white dude.
Yeah.
And I did see you and I was like, we're just the token white dudes.
Yeah. But then I was uploading all the videos. So I literally watched every video that ever went on to All Dev Digital.
Yeah.
And
you
then
like, it was worked like, there, huh?
Yeah. I worked there for 3 years and I uploaded all the videos on doing social media. And I saw that they bought some video from you and it was one with you and Blake in a grocery store.
Oh yeah.
And you were like crying. And it was like 10 steps, like how to
and
get.
And then I stacked a bunch of beer boxes.
Yeah, well,
we gotta
you
do
love
that
stacking
for a video.
Boxes, bro.
I love stacking
your
boxes.
Your favorite
dude,
thing
one
to
of
do.
Those videos I thought you did was gonna pop insane is you went to Coachella just as a frat guy and you had like 12 beer cases stacked on it.
Yeah.
And it was like a stick through it, someone fall, and he's like at the gate, he's like, excuse me. Let me in.
I'm like, I'm bringing beer for everyone. We needed to do that as
but
a video.
I remember it was like
that was one of my first ones that popped off on Facebook.
Yeah, but I just remember that video uploading it and I'm like, what the fuck? And I think I DM'd you. And then you had seen a video of mine or maybe saw the Zoomies stuff.
Who knows? We should go scroll all the way back.
Dude, let's
That'd
make
take
love.
Years.
I know.
We reply to each and every story of each other.
Yeah.
Make it a collage, guys.
Well, it was hard.
I love it.
It was hard because you didn't have a day job and I was still working there. So I worked like from like 10 to 6 every day. And you'd be like,
I was filming weddings, dude.
But you have like a flexible schedule.
I had like more,
You'd be like, yo, you're trying to film today? And I'd be at work. I'd be like, yeah, what time? Like 7 or 8? You're like, nah, 2 p.m. in Venice. I'm like, what kind of life is this guy living? Preachers go to Venice at 2. And now I'm like, fucking, let's do it, dude. 1 o'clock in Van Nuys, dog. Sounds like a Drake song.
It's there's traffic. I don't give a shit.
Yeah, but like,
that is
I was
true.
Just like, dude, this guy's so cool. Like, he just lives the YouTube life. His films at 1 o'clock on a Tuesday.
I was lucky to like not be able to, not have to work like on week.
Well, you were freelance.
Yeah.
You were doing weddings on the weekend, but.
I would just be like, yo. It's 11. Let's film at 1.
It's so like, funny what? because they, you still do that to this day. Like, it's like you've been the same person this whole time. You're just being like, yo, it's 2 o'clock. You want to go to Venice and yell at people as fuckboy magicians? And I'm like, honestly.
Sounds good, dude.
Yeah.
Honestly, yeah.
But I was like literally working and I was like, maybe I could leave work for an hour, go film a quick
thing. Right. You did say that.
Yeah. Because I was like, dude, I wanted his life so bad because I was like, he's full-time YouTube. Like, how do I make this happen?
Yeah.
And then I'd be like, I don't get out of work till 6. So.
I thought you were doing the same thing. I thought you were selling them videos.
No. I just literally worked there. And then they were like, yo, you work here. That's free content. Post your shit for exposure. I was like, okay. I guess I was getting paid.
Though.
Yeah, no, it was great. And I think that they really helped shape a lot of my comedy and whatnot and brought me the first pair of like eyes and whatnot. So
yeah. Yeah. I remember like selling my videos there. I was like stoked because they're like paying me. And it's like YouTube didn't pay that much at that time. And like, I like remember being able to like pay like my filmer and like Blake, and it was like 50 bucks.
Yeah, like, and you're like, slide them. They're like, dude, you don't have to pay me that. You're like, yeah, I got you.
I made money. You're making money. Yeah, it was, and so like, funny. I was like, yo, I'm a businessman.
They would share your video for like $300-$400 or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you could just post it a month later, and you're like, cool.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, but cool. Yeah, I think we finally collabed, and then after that, we're like, dude, we should yell at each other.
Do you even have a YouTube? You post your live stuff?
Dude, I'm so bad with YouTube. It's bananas. Like,
really?
But you're doing the right thing just focusing on TikTok, because it's like, I think
yeah,
you just
upload. Yeah, your TikToks go berserko.
Yeah, just pretty good, yeah. Just post all your shit on YouTube as like a backlog category
short. You can library. Do shorts too.
Yeah, you could post on YouTube post shorts. I started doing it. They all bomb, but it's fine. Okay. YouTube shorts is like, every time I talk to somebody at YouTube, they're like, you need to focus on shorts. And then I post shorts and they're like, not like that. They all bomb.
Yeah, shorts are weird. I don't know.
I don't understand.
Everybody that's why wants, I prefer pants. Guys, someone kill me.
All right.
But like my friend Liam, he's like big on TikTok, and he posts like just shit posts, like all mostly shorts, and like one of them has like 18 mil.
Yeah, you have what? To shit post. You have to just post every day.
Yeah,
same thing.
It's
this,
like
guy,
TikTok,
this guy,
yeah.
I know, Nick DiGiovanni, the chef kid on TikTok. He spam posts a cooking video like every day, and he has videos with like 30 million views.
Yeah,
and from the pandemic, he went from like 200k to now he's got like 2.2 mil.
Dang, that's
and
crazy.
I'm just like, oh, I'm sorry, I've been posting these sketches for the past like 5 years. But it's shorts, because what they say is it takes a while to get into the I don't know. Dude, you can say anything about the algorithm, I don't believe it. They're like, it takes a while to get
algae.
Yeah, it's got to test. It's got to smell you out. You post 10 videos, a short every day. I'm like, I don't know. I'm just going to start spam posting shorts. And
am I just going to post fucking shorts every goddamn day? I have so much stand-up.
No,
You should.
Well,
what are we doing here?
Short. It's over. Cut the fucking cameras. I'm going to be a short goddamn viral legend.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Well, Gableton?
Yes.
And get these, and you'll be a tall, short, viral legend.
Those boys got
some platform on them.
And also, wear a fucking thrift store, overly expensive band tee.
I'm an idiot.
Dude, this was $40 at a Brooklyn fucking thrift store, but you know what? When you're in Brooklyn, you gotta buy an NSYNC shirt sometimes.
You know what this is, dude? This is Stiff Socks merch, and it's all sold out, because we're fucking legends. All right,
no
guys.
No way. Limp Bizkit's what they call my dick!
Whoa, loud.
Is that what it means?
Loud, sorry.
Limp Bizkit? Gabe's ears are
bleeding. I don't know.
Oh, is Limp Bizkit short for whiskey dick?
I don't know.
Oh,
maybe.
Shit. Limp Bizkit.
Limp Bizkit.
Whoa.
That sounds like a British girl. She's like, your penis ain't wonky. You got a Limp Bizkit.
You got a Limp Bizkit on ye. It's a fucking cookie. You dumb UK bitch.
Oh, Jesus.
Mine is
sweet like a little cookie.
Yeah.
Well.
All right. Well, is that it? Are we here? Is that all?
That's it, yeah.
Dude, that's a podcast. This has been forever in the making. I don't know why we never had. I don't know. It's just like, I think I talked to you so much that I'm like,
we don't need to talk anymore. I FaceTime you like every day. You're like, I don't want this guy.
I know, but it's like, you're like so involved in somebody's life that you're just like, oh, why don't we just do a podcast? We're like, we should get the inventor of Chili's and Applebee's on the podcast to get like just insane people. We're like, how do we get Jeff Bezos' stepsister on here? Instead, we're like, let's just get the homies on it.
Yeah. So dumb. All right. Well, holy shit, dude. This episode has been wild and incredibly long and very, very goddamn entertaining.
Like our dicks, we're legends.
Well, oh, yeah.
As I always say, and every stupid ass influencer says, please go on Apple and
subscribe.
Spotify and rate, subscribe, and review. It actually really helps us out, gets us some more eyes. Also, we have a Patreon, guys. 4 extra episodes a month for only $5 is the goddamn price of a freaking cup of coffee. Entire backlog of Patreon episodes as well. We have legend Patreon episodes such as the Gabe interview. We interviewed Trev's girlfriend. They're crazy. So it's only $5 a month, 4 extra episodes. Go on patreon.com/stiffsockspod and go sign up. And that is it. Thank you, Chad, for coming up on. Oh,
there it is.
That was a little better.
Give Gabe one. Give Gabe one.
Give Gabe one, please.
Oh, dude, you get the ones where we do it from afar.
Oh, yeah.
We're in the midair.
All right, guys. Peace. We love you. Till next Wednesday. Goodbye. Love you. Bye.